Hi, I am your state senator, Linda Evans Parlette. There are less than 20 days left in the regular session, and let's hope there is no special session. The regular session is supposed to end on Sunday, April 26th. And just yesterday, Monday, April 6th, the Senate budget was passed. It took a little bit longer this year. Why? Well, the minority party did what minority parties are good at, and they just offered about 65 amendments, most of which the majority party turned down. But every one was a roll call vote, and we started at 9 o'clock in the morning on Thursday and ended up at 4:15 in the morning on Good Friday. So in other words, when most of you were sleeping, the Senate was working in these Senate chambers until the wee hours of the morning. Consequently, since I got to bed at about 5 o'clock in the morning on Good Friday, I skipped the Friday morning radio shows that we always do to district. So let me tell you a little bit about that budget. First of all, it fully funds K-12 education and deals with the McCleary lawsuit. It makes college more affordable. I'm excited about that because what it would do is reduce college tuition. And let's know that our state really has raised college tuition for so many years. We froze it in the last 2 years, but to reduce it will really help all of us, especially middle-class families. So that's almost like a tax break. It looks out also for the most vulnerable. That's always a priority for our budget, and there are no tax increases. I quoted on the floor of the Senate, Senator Hill, who said, "Tax increases should be the last resort, not the first response." The House, as you know, passed their bill earlier, and it increased the spending by 15%. But what it did not do is pass any of the bills necessary to implement the budget. So let me give you an example. Transportation. With all the goodies in a transportation package, you could do all of those projects. But if you don't do a gas tax to back it up, it's meaningless. Well, the House did the same thing with their operating budget. They passed a budget with all these tax increases, but they didn't take the tax votes that are necessary to make the budget balance. So time will tell. Does the Senate negotiate with themselves? Or do we negotiate with the House but use the Senate budget? Those answers I hope to have by next week. I have a lot of other things going on, as you recall. I've sponsored way more bills than I normally do this year. One in particular is a water bill, which is so important to our district. That bill number is Senate Bill 5491. And what it would do is allow the Wenatchee watershed and the Aniat watershed and others around the state who have followed state law and rules and brought people together. That means cities, counties, tribes, and work out a plan that fits the district. That would allow those watersheds to move forward. Well, the House has really messed that bill up, and so we will see how it passes, or if it passes, the House of Representatives. I'm really working on that because the city of Leavenworth and the city of Cashmere is relying on that piece of legislation to pass so they can continue to have growth and deal with their shortage of water. So those are just a few things I'm working on, and I look forward to visiting with you next week. By next week, we'll also know what the capital budget says and looks like. So until next week, thank you for the honor of representing you. Again, I'm your state senator, Linda Evans Parlette.